Underground elbows and bushings are also called separable connectors because they can be separated whenever there is a need. The dielectric silicone grease manufacturers supply with the elbows and bushings is one of the major reasons this is possible. This grease plays an equally important role when mating parts as it does when separating parts, because without the use of the supplied silicone grease, the separable connection could potentially turn into a permanent connection. But using too much silicone grease can also cause serious issues and unsafe conditions. When an elbow is plugged fully onto a bushing, it creates a tight fit between the bushing interface and the elbow interface. The supplied 4-gram grease packs give enough silicone grease to apply a thin, even coat of silicone over the entire surface of the interface. For large projects, Hubbell also offers larger 5-ounce tubes of silicone grease, but this does not mean that more grease should be applied to the bushing interfaces. When too much grease is used, three things can happen. The first is that the elbow won't fully latch onto the bushing since there is nowhere between the elbow and bushing interfaces for the extra grease to go. The second issue is air can get trapped between the interfaces and push the separable connector back off the bushings. This issue is more prevalent with elbow arrestor and insulating caps, but also happens with elbows. Third, if the separable connector does fully latch, it can become more difficult to remove from the bushing. Using plenty of silicone grease on the cable to help ease the installation of the elbow or cable adapter is perfectly acceptable, but excessive silicone grease on the interfaces is not. If you ever experience elbows that do not want to stay on the bushings or are trying to back off the bushings, try cleaning and removing all the grease from the interfaces, applying a thin coat of silicone, and reinstall the elbow onto the bushing. This should fix the issue, but if it does not, send the elbow and bushing back to the manufacturer for evaluation. Always operate elbows using a live lying tool of the appropriate length for the arc flash potential. Wear the correct PPE per your company's safe work practices, and check to be sure the elbow is fully latched using the yellow seating indicator ring on the bushings. When the elbow is fully latched onto the bushing, no part of the yellow indicator is visible. 50 to 200 pounds of force is required to latch a load break elbow onto the bushing, and this is difficult to achieve from a kneeling position and without a live line tool.